All right, we start off with our Yukon iCam 646. Absolutely beautiful out there. Just enough sunshine to make for a wonderful start. I hope you can get out there and enjoy today. It does look fake. It just looks like somebody painted it. It just looks absolutely amazing. And look at the foliage on the trees. I mean, we're pretty much there. We've got mostly green conditions out there, and boy, we've had a lot of rain lately to green everything up. As we take a look at our Channel 3 early warning radar, we are scanning the state dry. Good morning, good morning, good morning. It's time to rise and shine. It is a great start, and showers and thunderstorms are expected later, like around 5 p.m. Through about midnight tonight, and then they'll be gone by about midnight, 1 o'clock in the morning. It's all associated with a cold front that's marching in to the region. All right, now the numbers out there, not too bad. 42 in Willington, Litchfield coming in at 50. That's a great number. 51 in West Haven and New Britain, 51, even better. The typical overnight low is about 45. Let's check in with the other temperatures across the state. A little bit cooler there in northeast Connecticut at 43 in Putnam, 43 in Willimantic, and the warm spot is 53. So 10 degree difference between Putnam and Bridgeport, but that's pretty typical. A little bit cool there in northeast Connecticut. You might want to grab a light jacket or a sweatshirt as you're heading out the door. You're not going to need it by later this afternoon because the temperatures are going to be pushing into the low 70s today. As a matter of fact, 73 degrees by about 3 p.m. Notice the icons. They do go partly cloudy and then some scattered shower activity by about 6 p.m. in parts of the state, not at all parts of the state. Northwest Connecticut, you guys are going to get whacked a little bit sooner than the rest of us simply because you're going to be first to get that front. And then you'll notice the shoreline stays dry through 6 p.m. Doesn't look like we're going to get any rain along the shoreline until about 8 or 9 o'clock. Guys, look at this. Put on your sunscreen because I think I'm getting a burn right here just from looking at this iCam. That is spectacular. And we'll take you to New London, a little bit more in the way of cloud coverage, but still a very nice start. Look at this. Hartford, good morning to you. Rise and shine. Regional radar confirms we had some scattered showers between about 10 p.m. and 2:30 in the morning. Those are now gone. Some scattered showers are up to the north and west. This is all a part of a leading edge. Here's the front. Right here. You can see this is going to be marching into the state later this afternoon through this evening, and that could spawn a couple of showers and some thunderstorms possibly. And that is according to early warning futurecast. Tomorrow's weather today shows us an hour-by-hour depiction of not a whole lot going on until about 5 o'clock. Northwest Connecticut, watch what happens at 6 o'clock. Maybe a little lightning and thunder. 7 o'clock, it's still basically limited to northwest Connecticut. Lightning and the possibility of some thunder. This is 7 p.m. tonight, some heavy downpours. That trickles through central Connecticut around 8 o'clock tonight. 9 o'clock tonight, it's in northeast and southeast portions of the state, drying out for the rest of the state, and then it's all gone by about midnight tonight, and we get back to the nicer weather overnight tonight through early tomorrow morning. Highs today in the mid to upper 60s for the shoreline, low 70s elsewhere. Overnight lows tonight, not bad, pretty similar to where we are this morning, with showers and a few thunderstorms possibly tonight. And then tomorrow, 68 degrees. Thursday, increasing clouds. Looks like we're going to have some showers Thursday night. Friday looks like a super soaker. Yay! More rain. Yay! Saturday, it looks great. Sunday, increasing clouds with rain arriving at night through early Monday morning. So Saturday is definitely the better of the two weekend days. But Monday, not bad in the afternoon as the showers come to an end and the temperatures move into the mid-60s.